Acute traumatic spinal cord injuries may have a severe negative impact on long-term health and productivity. Prompt diagnosis and management of spinal cord injuries is key in limiting and, where possible, preventing permanent neurological deficit. Epidemiology. The incidence of cervical spine injuries is 5.25 times higher in males, with one-third of all C-spine injuries occurring in the age group 21 to 30. Motor vehicle accidents account for 44.6% of all C-spine injuries, followed by falls, gunshot wounds, and other. C-spine may be cleared clinically and/or radiologically. C-spine injury cannot be ruled out if any of the following are present: high energy injury or low energy injury with midline spinal tenderness, reduced level of consciousness, focal neurological deficit, intoxication, or distracting injury. Views obtained may be lateral, AP, or odontoid. This video will focus on the lateral X-ray. Always begin by checking the name and date. Confirm the view and then proceed with the systematic approach. AP X-ray. Check that the coverage is adequate. Look at the spacing between the spinous processes and then look at the bone. Note that fractures are often poorly seen in this view. Check the alignment, the soft tissues, and the edges of the image. Lateral X-ray. All vertebrae must be visible from the skull base to the bottom of T1. If T1 is not visible, then a swimmer's view may be necessary. A swimmer's view is an oblique view which projects the humeral heads away from the C-spine. Inspect the anterior vertebral line in green, the posterior vertebral line in orange, and the spinolaminar line in red. Note that the spinal cord lies between the posterior vertebral and spinolaminar lines. Trace the cortical outline of all the bones to check for fractures. The disc spaces should be approximately equal in height and symmetrical. Inspect the prevertebral soft tissue. Some fractures cause widening of the prevertebral soft tissue due to hematoma. Important bony landmarks are the pedicles, lateral masses, facet joints, and spinous processes. Odontoid view. This view is considered adequate if it shows the alignment of the lateral processes of C1 and C2. The distance between the peg and lateral masses of C1 should be equal on each side. Now that we know what normal looks like, we can spot the abnormal C-spine. Let's have a look. Pause the video to learn the pathologies. C1 Jefferson fracture. C2 odontoid peg fracture. C2 hangman fracture. Extension teardrop fracture. Flexion teardrop fracture. Unilateral facet dislocation. Bilateral facet dislocation. Prevertebral soft tissue line. Spinous process fracture. Created using Powtoon.